Welcome to EBS 345. Today we're going to see about water. All human beings, all living organisms need water. We need water for bathing, for cooking, for drinking, for washing also. Humans need water mainly for drinking and also for washing. Whereas the plants need water for living and growing. Okay, so the humans need water mainly for drinking and washing, whereas plants for living and growing. Okay, the planet Earth is known as blue planet. Okay, the Earth is known as blue planet because 3/4 of Earth contains water. So the water is blue in color. So the Earth is blue planet. If you see the Earth, you see it all mostly blue color because the Earth contains 3/4 of water. So that is why the Earth has blue planet. So the water occurs in so many ways. Okay, this 3/4 of water occurs in three ways. Okay, either they occur in oceans and seas, or they occur in ice or snow, or they occur in lakes, ponds, wells and rivers. Okay, the 3/4 of this water majorly occur as oceans and seas, or they will be occur in frozen state known as ice or snow, or they occur in the form of lakes, they occur in the form of ponds, wells and also rivers. So the water, every human being require, or every living organism required water. We require water for bathing, washing, drinking, cleaning purposes. Humans want water mainly for drinking and washing. Plants want water for living and growing. The Earth is known as blue planet because the Earth contains 3/4 of water, 1/4 of land. In this 3/4 of water, majority of water occur as oceans and seas, and some occur as frozen state such as ice and snow, and some other occur as lakes, ponds, wells and rivers. So we'll see what are the sources of the water. What are the sources of water? Okay, the first one is rain. Rain is the major source of water. When rain falls from the clouds, it gets collected in the ground. So the rain is one of the important sources of water. So what happens? Some of this water grows inside the underground, collected there and forms the underground water. So the second source is underground water. Underground water means the air, the rain which is fell from the clouds get collected in, goes inside the ground, collected there. We can use hand pumps, or you can use bore wells. This is the hand pump. Okay, this is called a hand pump. This, the underground water will be somewhere. This is like the underground water will be here. So if you hand pump it, due to the pressure, this underground water comes up through this, it will come here. Okay, this is a hand pump. Underground water is one of the important source. What happens? When rain falls from the clouds, goes deep into the ground and settle there. If you put hand pumps or the bore wells, due to the pressure, these underground water comes up and they comes out through the hand pumps or bore wells. This water is perfectly safe and you can use it for drinking also. And the other thing is you have ponds and lakes. What is a pond? Pond is a pond. Pond means large area of water surrounded by the land. There will be water also. This is the land, okay? Like this is the water and there will be a land, okay? This all will be the land. This all will be the land and only this is the water. This is called as pond. Ponds means large surface of the water will be surrounded by the land. Whereas the lake, what are lakes? Lakes are also the kind of ponds, but lakes are small in size. Like this can be a lake, okay? It has all the land. This is all the land, okay? This is the lake. So the lakes of two types: either it is natural, which is formed in naturally, or it is man-made, or we man-made means which is made by the man artificially. Like you can dig the ground to some part and make the lake. Okay, what are the sources of water? First one is rain. When rain falls from the sky, it gets accumulated or it gets collected, and we can use that as one of the sources of water. Next is underground water. Underground water, when rain fell from the sky, the ground, it goes deep into the ground and stores there. So we can use hand pumps or bore wells and get that water out. This water is perfectly fit for drinking. The next is ponds and lakes. Ponds. Ponds is a large area of the water surrounded by the land. Whereas the lakes. Lakes are also kind of similar to the ponds, but lakes are small in size. The lakes are two types. Either they are natural, which are formed naturally, or man-made, means which are formed artificially, like we dig the land and we form a lake. So there are also other sources. We'll see what are the other sources of the water. Rivers. Okay, the other source of the water is rivers. The rivers, there are two types of rivers: rain-fed rivers and snow-fed rivers. Rain-fed rivers means when rain falls from the surface, they get collected in these rivers. Like only in rainy season we see these rivers, because in summer they will be dry up. Okay, this means rain gets collected. Rain gets collected and forms rivers. Okay, that is mainly you see it is in the rainy season. In the summer season, this rain-fed rivers dries up. Example: Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri. Okay, snow-fed rivers. Snow-fed rivers means the rivers formed by melting the ice. Okay, snow-fed rivers means from melting the ice or the ice mountains, those water comes and forms these rivers. These are known as snow-fed rivers. The best example for this is Brahmaputra, Ganga, Yamuna. Okay, these are the mainly important rivers. The important rivers, the rivers are classified into two types based upon rain-fed rivers and snow-fed rivers. Rainfed rivers means the rain falls from this sky, gets collected in the rivers, and they form these rainfed rivers. These rivers you can only see them in the winter rainy season. We cannot see them in any summer seasons because they get dry up. The best examples are Godavari, Krishna, and Kaveri. Whereas snow-fed rivers, these rivers are mainly formed by melting the ice or the ice mountains. The best examples are Brahmaputra, Ganga, and Yamuna. These rivers can dry up at any season. This only on the summer season, but these can dry up at any season. And the last source of water is oceans and seas. Okay, so oceans and seas, what is ocean? Ocean is a large water body. The ocean is large water body, and there are mainly five different oceans. The five different oceans are Pacific Ocean, Arctic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Antarctic Ocean. Okay, so the large water bodies, they are mainly five ocean bodies: Pacific, Arctic, Indian, Atlantic, and Antarctic Ocean. Okay, so these are mainly the five important oceans. Seas. Seas are the also same to the oceans, but seas are small compared to the oceans. And these both contain salt water. So this salt water, you cannot drink this salt water. Okay, so they cannot drinkable. Oceans and seas. Oceans are the large water bodies. There are mainly five different oceans: Pacific Ocean, Arctic Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, and Antarctic Ocean. Sea. Sea is also a water body, but it is small than the oceans. So that is, these contain salt water. The oceans and seas contain salt water, and we cannot drink the salt water. So today in this class we had seen about the water and what are the different sources of water. The rain is one of the source, underground water is one of the source, the ponds, lakes, wells one of the source, rivers. Rivers are of two types: rain-fed rivers, snow-fed rivers. Rain-fed rivers means the rain gets collected and forms a river. Example, you have Ganga, you have Godavari, Kaveri, Krishna. And snow-fed rivers, the rivers which forms from the melting of ice or the ice mountains. Example, you have Brahmaputra, Ganga, Yamuna. Lastly, we have oceans and seas. Oceans means large water bodies. There are five different oceans, that is Arctic, the Pacific, Arctic, Indian, Atlantic, and Antarctic Oceans. Seas. Seas are also similar to the oceans, but they are small compared to the oceans. These both contain salt water. This salt water is not drinkable. So this is about today's class, and we'll continue this class in the next portions in the next class. Thank you.